I decided a long time ago that if I were ever in a position that I could do for some younger musician with people like Wynton, Max Roach, Dr. Billy Taylor, Grover Washington Jr., Red Rodney, Shirley Scott, Trudy Pitts, all these great musicians who took time out of their busy schedules to come and talk to us when we were in high school, then I would most definitely do the same thing. I know now about being a musician on the road, you don't have a lot of time during the day before you have to get ready to go to the club and do a sound check and, you know, eat your dinner and then go play the concert and then go to bed and then wake up and do it again. You don't have a lot of time in your day. I think back to high school and those great musicians who came and spent time with us, they really didn't have to do that. They would have been heroes to us anyway had they not done that. But the fact that they did do that made me want to give that back tenfold. My wife, Melissa Walker, and I, we started a program called Jazz House Kids 14 years ago. And it's based in Montclair, New Jersey, where we live. And the goal of Jazz House Kids is to give kids who no longer have an opportunity to have a music program in their school to come to us after school, and they can take private lessons, they can play in large ensembles, they can play in small ensembles. We have a summer camp, which culminates in the Montclair Jazz Festival. It's really wonderful to have been able to serve all of these kids in northern New Jersey over the last, you know, almost 15 years now. There's some very, very, very specific things that a young musician needs to think about. Where do you want to be in your career? Who do you want to play with? Why do you want to play with them? Find out what you need to do to play with that person. It's actually not that hard. There's not a lot of great musicians out here that could be a part of this family. So if you're really good, if you're really driven, if you're flexible, you work well with others, you can be out here. Then the other real basic thing I would tell a young musician is worry about being the best you can be as a musician. Don't worry about, you know, because, you know, young musicians, they get turned on by what they see in magazines, or this guy won this award, or this guy got this endorsement, or, you know, this guy's wearing these clothes, and it's this fluff that too many young people get hung up on, and it's not necessarily their fault, but I can say that the greatest musicians that I've been around, they don't worry about that. That came to them after they worried about being the best musician they could possibly be. So worry about being the best musician you can possibly be. Learn how to swing, learn how to read, learn how to play changes, learn how to be flexible, learn how to serve what a particular gig demands. You know, don't say, oh, this is what I do, you know, this is how I play. You know, a lot of musicians get hung up on that too. Don't be proud of the fact that you can't work with anyone other than your friends. That's ridiculous. I think we're all more or less official or unofficial advocates for whatever we love. I certainly never made a conscious effort to be an advocate, so to speak. I think what I love, which is this music, is so deep, you know, maybe I must have radiated something. Well, I don't know what the next 100 years of jazz are going to be, but the first 100 years, in the grand scheme of culture, world culture, 100 years isn't very long. Jazz is still a baby, you know, in many ways. So there's still a lot of developing to do. America itself has a lot of developing to do. So I think as long as there are musicians or people in general who are willing to push themselves as far as they can go intellectually and creatively, there will be no shortage of interesting, deep, and powerful music. And I don't mean intellectually and creatively in terms of how to sell records. I'm talking about in terms of boosting people's, their intellect, their awareness, their courage. That's what I feel real serious music does. It sharpens the mind, you know, it just doesn't excite the loins. It actually feeds the mind. It makes you want to do something positive. You know, I think that's what jazz is supposed to do to you.
Patricia McBride's trio, Christian Sands piano, Jerome Jennings at the drums.